In today's Canva tutorial, we're going beyond the basics and combining three powerful features of Canva to design an animated text effect using Bulk Create. After watching this video, you'll learn how to create a cool, engaging video for your social media in a super easy way. I'm Natalia, and I help you create better content and grow on social media, so let's do this. So the first thing we're going to do is to create a worksheet in Google Docs. Of course, if you have Excel or any other tool of this kind, you will be able to use it as well, as long as you can save it as a worksheet so that Canva can then read it. Now, I'm going to go ahead and open up this spreadsheet that I've already created. And as you can see, it is filled with different types of words to describe a powerful entrepreneur, if that makes sense. But of course, any text that you want to include as the background of your animation, you would be able to do it. So think outside of the box, think of the different services that you provide, for example, or, you know, different numbers or things like this that you can use to create that basis of the animation. So I'm going to show you exactly how to recreate that because I've used ChatGPT, or you can use the Canva Magic Write tool to generate those words for you. So I'll go ahead here at the bottom and add another spreadsheet, and I'm just going to rename it Text Animation just to be able to differentiate between the two, but these will be fairly similar. Now I'm also going to be a little lazy and just copy that top, but you can just fill all of your columns with the headers as is, and you can see that I've got all the different lines in here just to create a bit more of that variety. Now I'm going to head to Canva next and open up a doc in here. The first feature I want to use is Magic Write, and this is a pro only feature. So go to the description box right now and claim your free trial so that you can create fun graphics like this for a whole month and use the amazing templates and elements from the Canva library too. So I'll go ahead and open up Magic Write, and I'll just paste the prompt that I've used before. So I'm saying generate 10 inspiring and empowering nouns for a powerful entrepreneur. Of course, again, you would be able to just change that prompt to what you prefer. I'm also going to say 30 just so that I've got a variety and something to choose from, and then I'll click generate. All right, I'm happy with this, so I'll just go ahead and insert. And as you can see, it usually makes the first line as a header, so I'll just reverse that so that we've got all these words in here. And from here, I will be able to just cull them a little bit and choose the ones that I prefer to use. Okay, so I'm down to 10 different inspiring words that I found to be fun and cool to use within the graphic and not too kind of over the top, if that makes sense. So I'll just copy them over and go to my sheets and just paste them as is. And what I prefer to do is to just go to paste special and values only, just so I've got this nice list in here without having to deal with the extra lines. So what I'm doing from now is to copy all of them again from this sheet and then to paste them below just so that we've got a bit more of that quantity in here. Now I went down all the way to 81, so I'm just going to get back to the top like this to select all of them and then copy everything apart from the first line. So we're trying to mix it up a little bit. So I'm doing innovator at the front, and then I'm just going to copy that visionary and just fill it as the next one over, if that makes sense. So for the next line, I'm going to go ahead for catalyst. So I'm now skipping two lines, and I'm going to just drag it to the bottom and add it to line number 3. So I'm just going to kind of keep doing it until I have 6 different lines, and I'll explain exactly why I'm doing this while we're creating the template within Canva. So let's go for strategist in here, builder, just like this, and then connector, and the last one is a leader. Now, as you can see, we've got all the different columns filled, and I've got all of them going to around 81. Of course, if you have different text types, you would be able to go even further than this, but for this kind of an animation, this is absolutely fine with me. Now, what I'm going to do next is to go to File here at the top and go to Download to download it as Microsoft Excel, so XLSX file. Next, we're going to create a template in Canva to give Bulk Create something to work with. So I'm going to go ahead and create a video from here. I can use mobile video, Instagram reel, TikTok video, any of these will work as long as they are 1080 by 1920 pixels. So I'm just going to go ahead and click it in here, and I'll name this one text animation with Bulk Create. Great. So first, what I want to do is to fill this background with something a little bit kind of off black, a little maybe into a red a little bit. So I think this kind of a color works great. And then I want to use a photo as the basis of it. So I'm going to go to Elements. You can see that I've got the photos that I want to use in my recently used, but if you want to use the exact same ones, these were created by this particular creator within the Canva library. So you can search for Ekru Lila. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing it correctly, probably not, but if you search for it and use any of these keywords, you will be able to find it. So I'll just pop it in here and just spread it like this just to fill my whole design like that. And then I want to just draw up the opacity a little bit just so that this image is only in the background and it's not disrupting the flow of the text above. So once I'm done in here, I'll go to text and I'm just going to go ahead and add my heading, but I will change the font in here as well. So let me make it a little bit bigger. And from here, what I want to do is to go to the font panel and I want to use Bebas for this one. So let's find Bebas. This one is the one that I want to use, and I'll go ahead and choose bold for this. Now, I want to make it a little bigger, so maybe something around 160 would work great, and I'll center it, of course, and then spread the sides a little bit just so that I'm making space for the longer word. So as you can see back within our spreadsheet, if I just open it up for you, the longest word that I've got in here is probably trailblazer. So what I prefer to do is to make sure that everything fits nicely and that there's enough space for the word to actually work. So just like this, I'm just making it a little further than just the word so that I've got enough space for it, but I'll name this one line one, just like this. And what I want to do next is to copy it over. So I'm just hitting Alt or Option on your Macs and then just dragging this below just so I create another line, and I'll rename it to just so I've got an easy way to connect all the data from my worksheet. Now, because we've got six different lines in our spreadsheet, I'm going to just copy it over each time just to make sure that we've got enough of these lines to connect the data. Now that I've got all six lines, I want to align them perfectly. So I want them to be spaced out evenly. And I also want them to fill more of the space because they will act as a backdrop. So I'm just going to grab the last one and drag it a little lower, just like that. My camera is literally right in front of me, so it's obscuring my vision a little bit, but I hope you don't mind. And I'm going to drag this one above, just like this, maybe. And this almost acts as a parameter for my design. So now I'm going to select all of the text, and you can use a shortcut. I would normally use a shortcut, but if you go ahead to position and then choose space evenly. So I've got tidy up in here. This is the feature that I want to use. So if you click on it, you'll see that Canva will automatically space it out for me. And this means everything's equal, everything looks polished, and this is what I'm happy with. Now we're ready to use Bulk Create to fill that animation with the actual text. So I'll go ahead to Apps and scroll down to Bulk Create in here. Now you would be able to enter that data manually, but I do have a spreadsheet that I want to use. So I'll just click Upload Data. So this is the one that I want to use. And as you remember, I had the first sheet to use in here prepared as a preview for you, but I actually want to use the one that we've created ourselves. So I'll go for text animation in here, which is our second sheet. And as you can see in here, we've got a little bit of that preview. So we see all of that text filled within the six lines, which is amazing. We can continue. Now, the reason why I created all these six lines is because we've got six headings, six different columns in here. So I will start connecting. Now, what I want to do is to select my first text, right click it, and then you can see connect data in here, and I will connect it to line number one and do all of it for all the remaining lines. Now, as you can see, once my first one got connected, you can see this headline in here as line one, and this one is also highlighted in purple, which means that this is properly connected. So I'll do that for the rest of it and then be right back for you. Perfect. All of our lines are connected with the worksheet right now, so I'll hit continue in here. And as you can see, we just have a preview of all of these amazing words in here to fill our line. So I'll just hit generate 80 designs, and this should take us to another design from within Canva. Amazing. As you can see, we've got all the different 80 pages of text. And of course, these are separate slides on our very, very large video file. So I'll just make it a little smaller so you can see all of them or a part of them at the very bottom. And if I select all of them right now, I can just drag it maybe like this, just so you can see that this is actually an animation. But if I play it, you can see that it's very, very slow. And this is definitely not what we want. So what I want to do next is to actually just select all of them. So I'm hitting Control A on all of my pages below. And what I want to do next is to go to edit timing here at the top and go for 0.1 for all of them. So this is a way to quickly change the timing for all of the slides. And as you can see, all of them are now just 0.1 seconds. So let's play it like this. And you can see that now it actually just renders that whole animation perfectly. Great, I'm really happy with what it looks like, but just because we've got this video doesn't mean that this is the way I would leave it. What I want to do next is to actually use it as a background, so I want to export it. So I'll go to share at the top, go to download, and as you can see, MP4 is the suggested format. I'll select all the pages from here and just download them as is. Amazing, this is now exported, so I'll just click show in Finder. I do have this file on my other screen just for very handy access, and I'm going to go to the home page and actually create another video. So I'm going for mobile video again, and I'll just rename that title quickly in here to connector, just because I really like that word. So I'll say connector animation in here. Now, what I want to do next is to again use this file as the basis. So I'm just going to drag it from my other screen to upload it in here. And as you can see, it is uploaded straight away like that, and I can just use it to fill my whole screen like that. So as you can see right now, this is just the video. So we've got all the animations flowing without me having to worry about dispositioning any of the text lines or any of the background pieces. So I just have it as a whole video. Now, what I'm going to do again, I dragged it from the top just to crop it a little bit because I want access to the background. And again, I'm going to go ahead and just use something a little bit kind of off black, not exactly brown, but something brownish, just like this. And I'm just going to drop the opacity of this video right here, because again, I don't want it to be as much in your face, if that makes sense. I want it to be a little bit more dimmed. So this is what I'm using as the background. Next, what I'm going to go ahead and use is another photo from my elements. As you can see, this is another photo from the same photo shoot. So this is what I'm using as the basis. And I'm just going to drag it by the sides just like that, just to fill the screen with it and maybe move it along like this. Next, we're going to use the trusty background remover, everyone's favorite Canva feature. So as you can see, it worked very quickly. And this is now our removed background like this. So this is the portrait that I'm using as the foreground. Now, because I want to add a bit more depth, I want that foreground to be separated from the background a little bit more, maybe add a little bit more depth between the subject, the lovely woman in here with the background text. So I'm going to go ahead and edit from here. And then you can see the shadow effects in here. Now, what I'm going to use is the drop shadow from here, and I can just adjust the angle from here just like this, just so I've got this shadow just a little bit over in here. You may change it a little bit, and then blur amount because I want it to be nice and blurred, nothing too intense, but I can increase that intensity a little bit. And maybe I'll change the color of this shadow again so that this little kind of off black color, just to not be as harsh, if that makes sense. So I think I'm pretty happy with this one. I might even increase the distance a little bit more just to create a little bit more of that effect. I would also be able to use the glow effect from here, but I think I'm happy with this one for now. Now I'm going to close the shadows from here. And as you can see, what it did is that it just weirdly kind of squeezed the object because it creates more space for the shadow along the frame that we've got within this photo. I don't quite like this part of Canva, of the new photo editor. The previous shadows in the old photo editor. If you remember, never used to do that. I did prefer the other option because sometimes you just position your photo perfectly. And then when you add the shadows, it just, you know, it just messes up your positioning. But I can do it from here. So you can see that the bottom bit in here, I'm just attaching so that I don't have any kind of awkward lines in here, anything, any sharpness or anything of that sort. And I can also just crop it from the top because we don't need that kind of empty background in here. So I'm just going to go ahead and crop it a little bit, maybe, you know, center it a little bit more, just like that. Okay, I repositioned it a little bit further. I played with shadows a little bit more just to kind of perfect that shadow that I wanted to go for. Now, I'm very happy with what it looks like as is, but I want to add a little bit more depth, something in the foreground to be able to maybe add further text if I wanted to. I think I'm going to just leave it as is, but I will add that shading at the front. So what I've done in here is to add a shape. I'm going for the square in here, but of course, this square also pairs as a rectangle. So I'm just going to stretch it out. And what we're going to do is to change that color, that solid color, into a gradient. So I'm going to go ahead and add new color from here. And then from the gradient, you can see that it instantly changes it for you. Now, what I want to do is to add another one because I want a 3-point gradient. And what I'm going to use for the basis of the first one is something kind of red-ish, just like that, something to match the outfit from here. So I think this is something that I really like. And then maybe something quite dark, just like this. I'm just going to move the slider towards the red just so it, the tones are a little closer, but this part is pretty much grayish, and I'll maybe drop it to something around 70 in here. So I've got the opacity. So this is not opaque, this is transparent. And now the last one, I'm going to just completely move to zero. So this is completely transparent in here. And you can see that we've got the background peeking through here. So this is what it looks like. You can see how it behaves when I move it around. I'm just going to rotate it, or actually I, you know, really wouldn't have to, because if I go back to that gradient at any point, you can always jump back and actually adjust it. And I can just click on this style just to, you know, save myself the rotating, and I'll just use this one. So what I'm going to do in here is to fit it like this. And what you can do further is to, of course, kind of adjust it as you please. Okay, so this is how big I want it to be. And as you can see, we can preview the whole animation like this. And this is what it looks like. Again, I'm pretty happy without adding anything at the front. But if you wanted to, you would be able to add more text in here. So if I jump back to our original text, I can just grab it just to save myself some time in terms of just adding, you know, the same fonts and everything. I would make it, you know, bigger maybe, and, you know, add it in here, maybe keep adding the text like this. But I actually prefer for this to be very kind of blank and very clean like this. So this is the fun animation that I've created using all of these pieces. And of course, this is just 8 seconds. So if I ever wanted to have a bit more of that video, I want it to be a little longer, I could just go ahead and duplicate it. So you can, as you can see, you can use Command D or Control D if you're on Windows, and then just like this, we've got a longer video, which is now 16 seconds, but you can keep doing it just because our text in the background is actually repeatable, right? So this is what this whole video looks like. Again, this can be a fun way to incorporate more animated video styles for your social media, reels and maybe TikToks, or I would more so say reels than TikToks in that case, because TikTok is a little bit of a different beast. But for reels, just to have a little bit more of that funky feel to create more videos, you would be able to create something so simple like this. And at the very end, please do remember that if you want to have all of those animations rendered, you do need to download it as an MP4, which is the suggested format. So you want this in a video format. All pages are selected from here, depending on how long you want them, and then you can just hit download. And this just goes to show that you can be super creative with Canva and use the features beyond just the basics. Next, head on over to this video to learn how to create 50 social media graphics in 5 minutes and use Bulk Create the right way. Don't forget to tag me in your graphics because I love to see what you create after watching my tutorials, and subscribe because I have so much more in store for you. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.